And India has entered a new year with the most momentous security reform, the appointment of India's first Chief of Defence Staff. With a distinguished career behind him, General Bipin Rawat has retired from the post of Army Chief. He will now serve as CDS for a term of 3 years. What's making news? His uniform, his role and how it differs from the National Security Advisor, and why General Rawat says his head now feels lighter. Take a look.
The Army's sword.
हमें तीनों सर्विसेज जो हैं, उसका 1+1+1 का जो जोड़ आता है, उसको तीन नहीं बनाना है, उसको 5 या 7 बनाना है.
The Air Force's eagle.
So you have to achieve more through synergy and integration.
And the Navy's anchor.
Strive to achieve that in 3 years. Why should we not? Why should we at the very beginning only say it is not possible?
The uniform of India's first Chief of Defence Staff draws emblematic symbols from all three services. His peak cap, dress buttons, the belt buckle and the epaulette all have badges which represent the ethos of the three services. Today, General Bipin Rawat's tenure began with a farewell guard of honour as the Army Chief. He is now officially India's Chief of Defence Staff. How does he feel being the first man in the role?
My head is feeling lighter because I've had to take off that, you know, the so-called angled Gurkha hat which I've been wearing for 41 years. I have come back to the peak because this peak cap that I am wearing is to say that we are now neutral. The CDS will remain neutral. He will be neutral to all the three services within his own service, and therefore my head is certainly feeling lighter.
Contrary to how the 61-year-old general portrays it, he now has far greater responsibilities. His position is meant to bring in convergence between the Army, the Navy and the Air Force. He will head the Department of Military Affairs and act as a military advisor for the government. As Chief of Defence Staff, General Rawat could transform India's war fighting and power projection capabilities. But does his role clash with that of the National Security Advisor, who is already an integral part of India's security setup? Well, there's an old idiom, it takes two to tango. Likewise, there is much functional interplay between the roles of CDS and the NSA. Number one, the NSA heads the Defence Planning Committee created in 2018. It has all three service chiefs as members. The main agenda is implementation of security strategy in the country. The CDS, on the other hand, will head the Department of Military Affairs. His task is to provide undiluted military advice to the government. Number two, the NSA receives all intelligence reports from RAW and IB and presents them before the Prime Minister. The CDS in hierarchy is lower than an MOS rank. He will be the point person with information from an independent pool of military resources. Number three, the NSA is a cabinet rank. He works on inter-ministerial coordination and integration of inputs in forming national security policies. The CDS will have the authority to direct the three service chiefs on security issues and also create a theatre command when needed. Number four, as a precedent, the post of NSA can only be occupied by those who belong to the Indian Foreign Service. The CDS, on the other hand, can only be a four-star general, the senior most uniformed military advisor. The political leadership of the country has led the way. The military and bureaucratic leadership should follow suit. These structural changes should now facilitate reform. Bureau Report, Wion, World is One.